If a new viewer joins your stream and the quality is poor or it's lagging, they're gonna leave and never return, costing you the opportunity to gain a new follower or subscriber. So in today's video, I'm gonna share with you the best settings to use as a console streamer inside of OBS Studio. That way your viewers can enjoy your stream, they'll stick around and potentially turn into a new follower or subscriber. Let me know in the comments below if you use a laptop, a desktop, or a Mac to be able to stream. So once you have OBS open, you're gonna wanna come to the right hand side and select settings. So the very first thing we're gonna land on is the general tab. Now this is gonna be the first little pro tip that I'm gonna go ahead and give you. You wanna make sure that on the output, you have these two first check boxes checked. It's gonna go ahead and give you a prompt, that way you don't make a mistake and start your stream by accident or end your stream by accident. It actually prompts you to let you know, hey, do you want to start your stream, or hey, do you want to end your stream, giving you that confirmation. So make sure you have those two check boxes checked. Next, we're going to go ahead and jump to the section where it says stream. This is going to be very important, especially if you're streaming to Twitch. You want to make sure you have this checkbox checked where it says ignore streaming serving settings recommendations. The reason why is because it's going to cap you at 6,000, and if you're not a Twitch partner or a Twitch affiliate, you're not going to be able to go ahead and get a 1080p looking stream. It's going to cap you at 720. So listen to me, this is going to be a pro tip and it's going to help us when we dive into the output settings. So make sure you have that check. Next, we're going to move to where it says output. At the top, output mode, you're going to select advanced. Under encoder, you're going to select X264. Under rate control, you're going to select CBR. And then for the bit rate, you're going to put 7,750. Now, I know that's kind of like a weird figure, but that's going to be the figure you're going to want to put, especially if you want a 1080p looking stream. When you put 7,750, regardless if you're a Twitch partner, regardless if you're an affiliate, regardless if you're streaming day one, your stream is going to be 1080p 60. Okay, so make sure you have that. And the best way to determine whether you can have that kind of bit rate is by checking your internet speed. So what you want to do is you want to go to the description of the video, you want to go to speedtest.net, you're going to select go, and it's going to go ahead and test your internet speed. It's going to go ahead and give you your ping, your download, and your upload. The figure we want to focus on is your upload. You want to make sure that it's above 10. If it's above 10, you're going to be able to utilize the settings that I'm talking about in the video today and put it at 7,750. Your keyframe interval, you want to put it at 2. Your CPU usage preset at very fast. Your profile at high. And your tune at 0 latency. And that's going to be everything you need for the output section. Next, we're going to move over to where it says video. For your base canvas, you want to use 1920 by 1080. And for your output, you want to go ahead and match it the same at 1920 by 1080. If you do see some lag, you can go ahead and drop the output scale to 1280 by 720. But I recommend keeping it at 1920 by 1080 if you have the internet speed and the settings that I've put in already. So for the downscale filter, you're going to use bilinear. Okay, this is going to be the fastest, especially if you have it matched at 1920 double for the base and the output. You can use bilinear. That's going to give you the best quality possible. And then for the common FPS, you're going to want to list it at 60. Then you want to come to where it says advanced. And then for the process priority, you want to make sure you select high. Okay, for the color format, you want to use NV12. The color space, you want to put 601. And then the color range, you want to use partial. Then you want to go ahead and hit apply, and that's going to go ahead and give you the best settings to give you a nice quality looking stream. But before you go live, I want you to go ahead and check out this video right here where I share 5 tips to be a better console streamer. That way you grow your stream. I'll see you in the next video.